conversation with your neighbor. Say, neighbor,
neighbor.
How many of us
have prayed
for what we paid to get into? Come on, ask him again and say, neighbor, how many of us have prayed for what we paid to get into? Now look at that neighbor, another neighbor, and say, neighbor, I need the Lord to get me out of this. Come on, tell him again, say, neighbor, I need the Lord to get me out of this. Say, neighbor, I need the Lord.
But the Bible says, but Jonah rose up to flee
unto Tarsha. Instead of Jonah doing what God told him to do, Jonah went totally in the opposite direction. And one thing that God pointed out to me last night, he said, after I instructed him, he went away from me. Instead of him coming to me, Jonah turned and he fled from the presence of God. So he went in the opposite direction of God. And the Bible said, but Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarsha from the presence of God. And watch this. He rose up. Somebody say he got up from where he was. As soon as he got up, because he went the opposite direction that he was instructed to go, the first thing that he did do was go down. Are you paying attention to that? When you get away from the presence of God, the first thing that you do is you do go down. Don't let the devil tell you you're doing better because you got a few clothes and you got a little extra weave in your hair. You ain't doing no better. You ain't doing no better because you might be driving a better car. You ain't doing no better because you got a better apartment. You ain't doing no better because you got a better home, because now you have disconnected yourself from God. But watch this. The Bible said, from the presence of the Lord, and it went down to Joppa, and he found a ship going to Tarsha. So guess what he did? He paid the fare. So guess what? He paid to get ready to go down and to go through. Many of us have paid the way to go down and to go through. It cost us something. Come on, somebody. You paid with your money, and you about to pay with your life. I ain't gonna have no help up in here. So he paid the fare thereof. He went down into it to go with them unto Tarsha from the presence of the Lord. He got away from the presence of the Lord. He got away from the instructions of God. Yes, his assignment was to go to Nineveh, but he chose to go to Tarsha because he did not want to follow the instructions of God. How many of us today, God has instructed you?
Since you think you can run and you can actually But the Lord sent out a great wind into the sea. And there was a mighty tempest in the sea.
A storm. There was a storm in the sea. So God sent a storm out there to find Jonah.
Jesus.
Do you mean to tell me that it's going to take a storm that designated to find me for me to get it right?
Jesus.
That think because they read their Bible that they're super spiritual. Well, what is the word without you acting on the word? The Bible said the letter killeth, but it's the spirit that makes the letter come alive. So once you know the word, you're not using the word, you ain't walking the word, you ain't living by the word, you just know it.
So that the ship was like to be broken.
The ship was breaking up because Jonah was on it.
Then the mariners were afraid and cried every man.
They was upset because they knew. Now check this out. Jonah done went down to the bottom of the ship. Somebody say done went down a little bubble. And he is asleep while they trying to figure out where did the storm come from. You ever seen people come and start some mess, get the mess started up in your house, and then go home and go to bed? Stir all kind of confusion. By the time they leave your house, you and your husband is hardened, you and your children is cutting up. Come on, somebody. They done brought a spirit up in your house.
And cast forth the wares that were in the ship into the sea to lighten it of them.
They had to lighten the load. They knew that there was something on that ship that should not be on that ship. So look at somebody and say, Jonah had to get off the ship. There is a Jonah in your life that's got to be cut loose. There is a Jonah that you got to get rid of. Because since you got that Jonah, it ain't been nothing but trouble. Here comes a storm after Jonah gets on the boat. I ain't got no help in here. Anybody experience a storm, once you start dealing with particular people, it's time to cut Jonah loose. What else did it say?
But Jonah was gone down into the sides of the ship, and he lay and was fast asleep.
He was asleep. It didn't mean nothing to him. And the shipmaster did what? What did he say?
So the shipmaster came to him and said unto him, what meanest thou, O sleeper?
How you going to sleep through all of this? That's what's wrong with the church. We're going through hell half of y'all sleep. Do you hear what I'm saying? Here is Jesus is soon to come, but you sleep. I'm talking about storms. Amen. I prophesied these storms months ago. I told y'all there would be secret storms. They will come. Get you some candles, and here it is. God, let us see the purpose. house. Shouldn't have never let you on my ship. Shouldn't have never let you in my car. Now I got to lose stuff just because Jonah is here.
Jonah, somebody said Jonah had to get off that ship. And the Bible said, what else?
Call upon thy God. If so be that God will think upon us, that we perish not. And they said, everyone to his fellow, come and let us cast lots, that we may know for whose cause this evil is upon us. So they cast lots, and the lot fell upon Jonah. Then said they unto him, tell us, we pray thee, for whose cause this evil is upon us. What is thy occupation?
And what is it that you do? What kind of work do you do? What country did you come from? Who do you work for? What caused this to happen to us? And what did it say?
What is thy country? And of what people art thou? And he said unto them, I am a Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, the God of heaven, which hath made the sea and the dry land. Then were the men exceedingly afraid, and said unto him, why hast thou done this? For the men knew that he fled from the presence of God.
They knew! As soon as he said who he was, I'm a Hebrew, I believe in God. But as soon as he said who he was, they knew he had fled from the presence of God. If you're running from God, don't run over here. If you're running from God, don't get in my car. If you're running from God, no, you can't sleep in my bed. If you're running from God, I need some help up in here. You got people sitting up in here right now. You have called yourself being in the church for over 40 years, but you still ain't obeying God. You're running from the presence of God. Excuses. God got a storm for you. God said, I got a way to show you that you're going to obey my voice. He said, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Watch this. What else did it say?
Because he had told them. Then said they unto him, what shall we do unto thee, that the sea may be calm unto us? For the sea rocked and was tempestuous. And he said unto them, take me up and cast me forth into
the sea. Throw me overboard. Go ahead on.
So shall the sea be calm unto you. For I know that for my sake this great tempest is upon you. Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to bring it to the land, but they could not, for the sea rocked and was tempestuous against them.
That was an angry sea. Yeah. It was an angry sea. And what else?
Wherefore they cried unto the Lord and said, we beseech thee, O Lord, we beseech thee, let us not perish for this man's life.
Don't take our life because of this man, because of this disobedient person. Many of us, and some of y'all are going to get mad, and I'm good on that. But many of us are living with disobedient people. They are disobedient. And they sit up. But you don't understand. You're going to have to give an account for every word that has come out of your mouth. Amen. Tell somebody, cut Jonah loose. Watch this. Read on real quick. Let me go.
And lay not upon us innocent blood. For thou, O Lord, hast done as it pleased thee. So they took up Jonah and cast him forth into
the sea. Going overboard. Watch this. Some of the stuff that we're going through in our house is because we have rebellious mates. We have mates that have calling on their lives and they have not obeyed God. And God keeps stirring and stirring and stirring. here. Watch this.
And the sea ceased from her raging. Then the man feared the Lord exceedingly and offered a sacrifice unto the Lord and made vows. Now the Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow.
God put the fish down there. Look at somebody and say, if you don't obey, God got something for you.
Read on.
Now the Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow Jonah.
To get Jonah. Not the shipmaster, not the mariners. This fish was designed, it was instructed to get Jonah. There is something that has been instructed to get you. Since you think it's a game, you think you can keep playing with God.
What did it say?
And Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and 3 nights.
Watch this. Jonah rekindled his prayer life.
Yes, he did.
He rekindled his prayer life.
Amen.
He said, wait a minute, I got to pray. I know how to get out of this if God will be merciful to me. If God will show me grace, I know how to get out of this. Go on, read.
Then Jonah prayed unto the Lord, God, out of the fish's belly, and said, I cried by reason of mine affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. Out of the belly of hell cried I, and thou heardest my voice. For thou hast cast me into the deep, in the midst of the sea, and the floods compassed me about. All thy billows and thy waves passed over me. Then I said, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again toward thy holy temple. The waters compassed me about.
If you get me out of this, Lord, if you get me out of this, you ain't got to worry about me serving you. Lord, if you get me out of this, you ain't got to worry about me getting to church on time. Lord, if you get me out of this, you ain't got to worry about me preaching no more. Lord, if you get me out of this, I won't go back.
What it say?
The waters compassed me about, even to the soul. The death closed me round about. The weeds were wrapped about my head. I went down to the bottom of the mountain.
Bound them up in the sea. Finish reading.
The earth with her bars was about me forever. Yet hast thou brought me up my life from corruption, O Lord my God. When my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord. And my prayer came in unto thee, into thine holy temple. They had observed lying vanities, forsake thy own mercy. But I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving. I will pay that I have vowed. Salvation is of the Lord.
I mean, he tell me whatever I owe, I'm going to pay my vows. Lord, I'm going to get back in church. Lord, I'm going to serve you again if you get me out of this. Keep on reading. Watch this. I want you to pay attention to this.
And the Lord spake unto the fish, and it vomited.
And who spoke to the fish?
Lord.
Jonah could have talked to that fish all day. That fish wasn't doing nothing until that fish heard the voice of God. God instructed that fish to be there and to get Jonah. I want you, to swallow Jonah on thus and thus today and thus and thus a time. And if Jonah don't pray and pray right, Jonah gonna die in the belly of the whale.
Hi, this is Pastor Janice Caslin of the New Deliverance Outreach Center. We're so happy that you've tuned in to our broadcast, and we're hoping that you would come by and visit us real soon. We're located at 14538 Mineta, Houston, Texas, 77035. For more information, you can contact us at 713-728-8288. Again, thank you for tuning in.